Hello and welcome back to TJ's Music Vault. I'm TJ Randolph and I'm sharing the various songs from the soundtrack of my life, going back from the 70s all the way up to the early 2000s. I am a 70s baby, but I grew up in Oklahoma before we moved from California. Lived in California until about 1979, Los Angeles specifically, and then moved to Oklahoma City thereafter. So my mom, I thank my mom for the gift of music because she exposed me and my sister to various genres. And of course, moving to Oklahoma, there was only certain music that we had available to us on the radio. So I have a healthy appreciation for many songs, many genres of music. Today is a second review of Pebbles. This song is Always. This song was released January 1st of 1990. I already told y'all what I was doing in 1990. Straight on the University of Oklahoma. I had just pledged my sorority in the fall of 1989. So I was a brand new Delta on the University of Oklahoma's campus. Ooh! So I was really quite full of myself, I must admit. But anyway, the reason why I'm playing this song right now is because I also said that I was going to share songs from me and Mr. Randolph's love story. And this particular song, Always, was played during our wedding reception. And I wanted to surprise him for our wedding reception. So I had taken dance lessons to do a routine. I work with a dance instructor to come up with a routine to do for my husband to this song on our wedding anniversary. And as you would listen to the words, it completely describes how I feel about Mr. Randolph. You have Pebbles, but who's also featured on this song is her cousin Sherelle, who was also a popular R&B artist in the 80s and 90s. So I'm going to share this song with you and let me know what you think. It's one of my favorite songs. It just sums it up how I feel about Mr. Randolph. So let's get into it. Uh-oh, start too soon. Let's start over. Let's do it.
Sherelle. Yes, ma'am. Have you ever loved someone so much that you could feel it deep down in your soul? Girl, I truly have. Well, this is how I feel about the one I love. Let's sing it together.
Are you taking this ride with me? Are you feeling the love emanating from this song? I still get emotional. I know y'all don't know who I am, but I am 54 and three quarters because I'll be 55 next month. I met Mr. Randolph at the age of 51. I thought love, romance, relationships, marriage was pretty much over for me. I'd gone through a very serious and even pretty much life-threatening situation in a previous relationship before I met Mr. Randolph. I wasn't sure if I could trust my own judgment. And I was very vulnerable. But after going through therapy and, you know, regaining my confidence in my own judgment and allowing myself to open up to someone and not allow the hurt from past relationships to interfere with what could have been, I took a chance. And Mr. Randolph showed me a love and a safety that I have never felt. So when I would listen to songs and the song came on the radio again, it's a song from 1990 on Sirius. It reminded me of, you know, my college years, but also it said to what I feel about Mr. Randolph now. So let's continue. Needless to say, Mr. Randolph was quite surprised, and it was PG because we had kids at the wedding, okay? But I wanted to do something to express to my friends and family what he has done for my life. And I really, you know, again, I'm sorry I have to say it, but I feel so bad for these young people. Because they don't understand or appreciate music and the words and the melody that come from songs like this. And also, it's funny because when I started dating Mr. Randolph, and we still do this because he's a truck driver, so when we are apart from each other, we send each other love songs. And this was one of the songs I sent to him when we started dating. So I'm giving y'all some free game. You understand me? I'm trying to help y'all youngins understand what romance is. And for us old heads who may have forgotten, I'm trying to re-engage you. Okay? So let me know what you think in the comments. And until next time.